Hamanat, Neoton, Rudy Ortega Jr., Tomiyar Pasivitan Tatavitam. Hello, my name is Rudy Ortega Jr. I'm the tribal president of the Fernandino Tatavian Band of Mission Indians.
My tribe is a coalition of lineages originating in the Simi Valley, Santa Clarita Valley, San Fernando Valley, and Antelope Valley. Dear community, I come to you today to talk to you about the importance of what the tribe is pursuing and what we are asking as a tribal nation. In recent news, you may have heard that the tribe requested a resolution from the city of San Fernando to replace the street name McClay Avenue to Tatavian Tribe Avenue.
McClay Street Avenue needs to change.
Because McClay evicted our peoples from our land, we were not made a federally recognized tribe.
The reason why we're seeking this is because of the injustice that occurred to our ancestors, the original people of Pachinga, now known as San Fernando, whose stories have not been forgotten. Specifically, we're talking about the land disposition that occurred to Rogelio Rocha, our tribal captain, in the 19th century, who fought from the Mexican period to the American period to preserve our ancestral lands. Captain Rocha had title to the land now known as the City of San Fernando. The land offered a safe space for lineages to gather and practice traditions within the privacy and protection of that land. It was also one of the last remaining land grants held by our tribe in the American period that wasn't removed due to unpaid taxes like the others were. From the 1870s and onward, ex-Senator McClay began evicting our people from the land through two methods, the courts and brute force. First, my great-grandfather, Antonio Maria Ortega, was evicted from San Fernando, taken to Los Angeles Superior Court and ordered to pay hundreds of dollars of fines. After purchasing the land surrounding Rocha's property, ex-Senator McClay continued evicting our people. At over 80 years old and without writing or speaking the foreign language of America, our captain fought for the lands until his death.
After the evictions occurred and some very adverse publicity was circulated about McClay and Porter in the Indian Rights Association brochures, McClay tried to defend what they had done by claiming that they had afforded Rogelio Rocha and his family and others various forms of compensation and alternative residence to ease the pain of the eviction. But it was clear from affidavits that the Indian Rights Association obtained from DeSilis, from Rocha, and even from the sheriffs that had carried out the eviction, that no such offers were made. The eviction itself was brutally harsh to Rogelio Rocha and the others who were living on the land, and whose land it had been for thousands of years.
Today, not many people know who we are or realize that we are still here. I ask that you support us and learn who we are as Native people in Los Angeles County and how we contribute to the community, serve our country, and persist even though, truthfully speaking, we were supposed to be erased. Our mere existence alone is a miracle.
No more excuses when it comes to discrimination, oppression, and further victimization of victims. We are at a time where we need to come up with solutions to acknowledge true history and move forward with that reconciliation. Why? Because that's a part of healing. You cannot heal historic trauma without actually doing the work and finding ways to help people who are victims.